welcome to your line work for your black stripe or for pattern Chung Mu Tul. So first cut line work. Again, this is the line work you need for your black belts. So we've got to see a big improvement now, but we'll get straight into your line work. So your first combination is a knife and twin block and inward knife and strap. So it's from L stance. So it's a knife and twin block, which you know already from yellow belt level. Then you're going to step out, inward knife and strike. Okay. So from your L stance, show me a knife and twin block. Then I want you to step out into walking stance. And as you step out, concentrate on doing the inward block with your inward knife and strike with your top hand. Just concentrate on this hand and strike. And you'll find that this hand comes up automatically. Now, I know some instructors will teach you exactly where to put this hand, but the fact is it is just a reaction force. It's not really doing anything. So it just ends up where it ends up. Okay, so you show me a knife and twin block and then concentrate on this hand striking in. And this hand will come up higher than your head, and this will strike to the neck in walking stance. Okay, so show me that again, coming forwards, knife and twin block. Ready? Slip out into walking stance and strike. Okay, and you'll find this hand comes up automatically. And again, so knife and twin block, slip out, inward knife and strike. Okay, so just like Chung Gun and Toige, you're slipping out from L stance to walking stance just the same way. So moving backwards, knife and twin block. Concentrate on the top hand, and this hand will come up automatically. Backwards knife and twin block, step out, go. Knife and twin block, step out, and it should, like I keep saying, come up automatically, okay? So coming forward, show me that again. One, two, ready, go. One, step out, two, go. Step out, and then moving backwards. Knife and twin block, and step out. Okay, so that's your first piece of line work. So I'll do that one more time for you. So L stance, knife and twin block, step out, and concentrate on your top hand. Step out into walking, concentrate on this hand. And backwards three times. And again. Again. Okay, so your second piece of line work or combination from Chung Mu looks like this. I'll show it you first. So it's a low block in L stance. Step out, grab the head, knee, and then step back to a ridge hand strike to the front. So a ridge hand sometimes looks like this, but this is to the front. Okay, so to the front, it's L stance, low block in L stance, which is unusual. So it's the first time I think you've done it in L stance. So low block in L stance, step out into walking stance and grab the head and knee. Step back into walking stance and show me a ridge hand to the front. So your knuckle is prominent, so your thumb must be underneath and strike into the front here. Okay, so coming forwards, put your left leg in front, L-shaped stance and show me a low block in L stance. Step out and grab the head and knee. Step back into walking stance and show me a ridge hand with your back hand, okay? And again, this hand should be underneath. So coming forward, L stance, lower block in L stance. Step into walking and grab the head and knee, and then step back, ridge hand. So coming forwards again, L stance, lower block. Step forwards and grab the head and knee, and then step back and ridge hand to the front. Okay, so moving backwards, L stance. Low block, step your front foot out and grab the head at the same time into walking stance and knee, put both hands out and strike ridge hand to the front. So moving backwards, L stance, low block, step out and grab the head, knee, two hands out and ridge hand to the front. And again, so moving backwards, L stance, low block, step out and grab the head and knee, then step back, ridge hand. Okay, so I'll show you that again. Three times forwards, three times backwards. Are you ready? Put your left leg in front, L stance, low block. Step forwards into walking, grab a knee, two hands out, ridge hand to the front. Forwards, one, step out, two, knee, three, ridge hand, four. Forwards, go. L stance, low block. Step out, grab knee, step back, ridge hand. Okay, last time moving backwards. One, two, three, four. Moving backwards. One in L, Two in walking, three, four, and finishing walking. And last time, L stands low block, step out, grab a knee, step back, ridge out. Okay, and barrel. So that's the second combination from Chung Nu. Okay, so third combination now that I teach my students is a U-shaped block and a jump 360. It's quite hard to do when you're cold. So in the pattern, the U-shaped block is in a fixed stance here. U-shaped grasping block. Again, this isn't new, you did it in Chung Nu, okay? In Chung Gun. So you did it in Chung Gun. So here, and then you got to jump 360, landing an L stance with a knife and guard, okay? So from here, you jump all the way around, landing an L stance with a knife and guard. You don't land and then knife and guard, you land with the knife and guard, okay? So from the fixed stance, with a U-shaped block, you jump and land in that knife hand, in an L stance, okay? So, again, you might find if you've never done this before, that you fall over a lot, or you don't jump straight up, you might jump at angles, falling over. A lot of people, in fact nearly everybody does it. Sometimes you get it right first time, and then you start falling over and going at angles. So don't worry about it. It's extremely normal for everyone to fall over. Okay, so start with your left leg in front, fixed stance, and show me a U-shaped block, then jump backwards, and land in an L stance with a knife hand. Okay, then coming forwards, fixed stance, U-shaped block, then you're going to jump backwards, lift your knees up, and land in an L stance with a knife hand. Like I said, one way is better than the other. So forwards go U-shaped block, in fixed stance, jump backwards, and land in your knife hand. Okay, so it looks a lot easier than it actually is to perform, but once you get used to it, it's okay. Now, when you jump, you'll probably go through loads of variations where you're jumping your feet together like that, that's wrong, or you'll jump, tuck your knees up like that, so that's wrong. So when you jump, you've got to have your feet and your knees apart like that, because this is building you up to do a jump spinning hook kick. And when you jump, if you took your knees up and then kick out at the top, you automatically do a hook, yeah? So that's what you're building up for. So you must tuck your knees up when you jump. So let's do it again. So coming forwards, U-shaped block. When you jump backwards, lift your knees up, okay? So jump backwards and tuck your knees up. Now, you'll find that you might jump the wrong way as well. You might jump forwards instead of backwards, but don't worry about it, it's just practice. So forwards again, U-shape, tuck your knees up, and land in that L stance. So coming forward, U-shape, tuck your knees up, and land in that L stance. Have we all got it? You're gonna make me show you again, aren't you? So let's show you one more time. So from fixed stance, show me the U-shape block, and you are jumping backwards, 360, land in the knife hand, and the most important thing is you tuck your knees up when you jump, okay? So tuck your knees up, and then land. Forward U-shape, tuck your knees up, and land. Coming forward U-shape, tuck your knees up, and land. Okay, coming forward U-shape, jump, tuck your knees up, and land. Okay, have we all got that line work? Fantastic, it's quite hard to do, but practice, practice, practice until you can keep your knees up. Land all the way around, because you will land halfway sometimes. So you've got to finish in the same place you started. And remember, don't do this when you land. You must land in this position. So I'll show you one more time. So from here, you jump, and you land in this position. It doesn't come from the corner. Okay, so Junbi. Right then. So let's get my breath back a second, and then we'll go on to the last piece of line work that I teach for Chung Nu. So Chung Nu now, your last piece of line work is a high section checking block, and then walking forwards, twin upset palms. Okay, now there's only four pieces of line work I teach. We could break it down even more, which I might do. I might add some on in a bit if I can think of some. Okay, so for this one, L stance, high section checking, and then slip out, twin upset palm. Okay, so coming towards the camera from here, the same as if you were doing low. From here, high section, palm open, yeah? One. Okay, so it kind of comes forwards, out in front of you, and the power stops when your hands cross. And that's in L stance. And then walk forwards, twin upset palms. Okay, so come forwards again from here. Ready? And then just step your front foot out, sorry, and twin. Okay, so let's do that again. So left leg in front, from the sides of your chest and a bit wider. There's no fixed start position the higher up the grade you go. It's just where you can generate more power. So you can start within your armpits if you want, but I generate more power from slightly wider. So from slightly wider, high section, then slip, pull back halfway, slip out, twin upset palms. So coming forwards, X-checking, step out, twin upset palms. Coming forwards, X-checking, step out, twin upset palms. Okay, so moving backwards, let's do that again. Stepping backwards, X-checking, slip out, twin upset. Moving back, X-checking, twin upset. Checking, twin upset. Okay, and barrel. Now, I'm aware that I'm only going forwards and backwards a couple of times now, but you are high grade, so you will pick it up pretty fast now. All you got to do is, if you're struggling, is just rewind, 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 okay? Now, there is a step scissor flying sidekick in this, so I'll try and show you, okay? So you're going to step, then scissor, and then show me a sidekick, okay? It's hard to do when you're cold, which is why we've put the more advanced kicks into individual tutorials, okay? So we start from a knife and guard, and you're going to step, scissor, sidekick, land and knife and guard, all right? So that's something you can practice in your own time. We'll start with your right leg back, because that's what you would be doing in the pattern, and from a knife hand. So your right leg is your stepping leg, your left leg is your scissoring leg, and then your right leg is your kicking leg, okay? So coming forwards, ready from here, step, scissor, sidekick, land in a knife hand guard. Okay, so one more time, ready from the knife hand. So steps is a sidekick, and then land knife and guard. Okay, I'll try and show you that from the side view if I have enough space in here. So it's a step, scissor, and then sidekick, okay, with your right leg. So step, scissor, sidekick, land in the knife and guard. So one more time, and right leg back. So step, scissor, sidekick, land in the knife and guard. So that's your line work, basically, for Chung Wu level, for first cup. So have fun practicing that, and thank you for listening.